No more pain, no more suffering. Tomorrow will change. Where am I? Where am I? Where am I? We'll make our dreams come true. In unity, me and you, we're African queens. Where am I?
Everybody, welcome to the African Queen Show, and I'm your host Gloria Mangi, and I got a jam-packed show for you this morning, and we got a twist for you. Yes, a twist. So before I even get into that, I got some interesting stories for you that's going to be later on in the Royal Trends, and it's all about education, and we're having some famous women. We're going to be talking about some famous women such as Shakira, Malala. I know some of you guys know who she is, just to name a few. I also have an interesting research that shows how fathers in Kenya are not as invested as their female counterparts. Interesting. You definitely want to hear what all that is about. And I got a twist, as I said earlier on, a twist for you. Instead of in the throne room of having a guest, I decided why not have some spoken word. I absolutely love spoken word. Now, what is spoken word? Spoken word is a form of poetry that is, instead of, you know, written down on a piece of paper, it's written to be performed, and it focuses on such things as your gestures, your movement, your facial expressions, the way you say words, and it's absolutely amazing, and it's used a lot of times to get a message out. Just like how rap back in the days was a form of liberation movement for a lot of African Americans back in the States when they're going through discrimination and segregation in the communities. Well, they decided that they also have a voice. So I got some interesting spoken word from some very famous spoken word artists, well known, and they're talking about the subject that we're going to be talking about this morning. It's all about education, as I said, and they are talking all about that. I don't know about you guys, but I cannot imagine being told that I cannot go to school because of my gender. Take a listen.
We speak of our rights. We speak that there should be equality. There should be equal rights for both boys and girls. Education must be compulsory in every country, especially in developing countries, for every child. And I think that the governments and all other organizations must focus on the education, because I believe that education finds solution to all the issues that children are facing. We need to speak and we need to fight, but through books, through pens, and through our voice. I want all the organizations to focus on education, because education is very important. If you educate a child, it does not only mean that you educate him, you also find a solution for poverty, for the child labor, for child trafficking, as well as you bring a change in their mindset. We must change the mindset of the new generation. We must tell them about the whole world. We must tell them about peace. And we must tell them about tolerance. I think education is necessary. So if the organization is focused on education and make it its top priority, I think that would be a great idea.
Wow. She is such a powerful young woman. If she doesn't inspire you to stand up for something that you strongly believe in, I don't know what. Do girls have a right to be educated? And if no, why? And if yes, why? You can tell me your thoughts and what you know is happening. I also want to hear your stories as well. You can also holler at us on the Facebook page, facebook.com/African Queen Project.
Step into the throne room with your host, Gloria Mangi.
And we are back, and you're still listening to the African Queen Show, and we're on this segment known as Throne Room. Now, what is Throne Room? Throne Room is where we have guests and we talk about the topic at hand. Now, I've got a twist for you this morning. We're not going to do it the conventional way where we bring a guest and then we talk with them. No, I told you earlier on about something called spoken word. This spoken word artist comes from England, but he's of Nigerian descent. His name is Sully Breaks, and he's a visionary undaunted by the restrictions found in conventional poetry. Now, leading him to push boundaries in a bid to inspire and inform a generation. Now, he's an artist, a speaker, and a writer. And Sully is often considered an inspiration by those who have met, watched, or listened to him. Now, unbeknown to most, this controversial poet has a law degree from the University of Sheffield, but it's hardly even used. He says, upon leaving university with fewer job prospects than when he had started, he decided to pursue a career in poetry, and he was fueled by his disbelief in his current formal education system. Now, he speaks a lot about education in his poetry. Now, one of the spoken words that he speaks about is all about why he loves education, but doesn't like the system. He says, why I hate school, but love education. So take a listen to this. You definitely, definitely, definitely want to hear what he has to say about this.
Why? Let me tell you what society will tell you. It increases your chances of getting a job, provides you with an opportunity to be successful. Your life will be a lot less stressful. Education is the key. Now let me tell you what your parents will tell you. Make me proud. It increases your chances of getting a job, provides you with an opportunity to be successful. Your life will be a lot less stressful. Education is the key. Now let's look at the statistics. Steve Jobs, net worth, $7 billion, RIP. Richard Branson, net worth, $4.2 billion. Oprah Winfrey, net worth, $2.7 billion. Mark Zuckerberg, Henry Ford, Steven Spielberg, Bill Gates. Now here comes the coup de grace. Looking at these individuals, what's your conclusion? Neither of them, in being successful, ever graduated from a higher learning institution. Now some of you will protest, like, you know, money's only the medium by which one measures worldly success. And some of you even have the nerve to say, I don't do it for the money. So what are you studying for? To work for a charity? Need more clarity? Let's look at the statistics. Jesus, Muhammad, peace be upon him, Socrates, Malcolm X, Mother Teresa, Spielberg, Shakespeare, Beethoven, Jesse Owens, Muhammad Ali, Sean Carter, Michael Jeffrey Jordan, Michael Joseph Jackson, were either of these people unsuccessful or uneducated? All I'm saying is that if there was a family tree, hard work and education would be related, but school would probably be a distant cousin. If education is the key, then school is the lock. Because it rarely ever develops your mind to the point where it can perceive red as green and continue to go when someone else says stop. Because as long as you follow the rules and pass the exams, you're cool. But are you aware that examiners have a checklist? And if your answer is something outside of the box, the automatic response is a cross. And then they claim that school expands your horizons and your visions. Well, tell that to Malcolm X, who dropped out of school and is well-renowned for what he learned in a prison. Proverbs 17:16. It does a fool no good to spend money on an education. Why? Because he has no common sense. George Bush. Need I say more? Education is about inspiring one's mind, not just filling their head. And take this from me, because I'm an educated man myself, who only came to this realization after countless nights in the library, with a can of Red Bull keeping me awake till dawn and another can in the morn, falling asleep in between piles of books which probably equated to the same amount I had spent on my rent, memorize equation, facts and dates right down to the letter, half of which I'd never remember and half of which I'd forget straight after the exam and before the start of the next semester, asking anyone if they had notes for the last lecture. I often found myself running to class just so I could find a spot on which I could rest my head and fall asleep without making a scene. Ironic, because that's the only time I ever spent in university chasing my dreams. And then after nights with a dead mind, I'd then find myself in a queue of half-awake student zombies waiting to hand in an assignment. Maybe that's why they called it a deadline. And then after 3 years of mental suppression and frustration, my proud mother didn't even turn up to my graduation. Now, I'm not saying that school is evil and there's nothing to gain, but all I'm saying is understand your motives and reassess your aims. Because if you want a job working for someone else, then help yourself. But then that would be a contradiction, because you wouldn't really be helping yourself, you'd be helping somebody else. There's a saying which says, if you don't build your dream, someone else will hire you to help build theirs. Redefine how you view education. Understand its true meaning. Education is not just about regurgitating facts from a book on someone else's opinion on a subject to pass an exam. Look at it. Picasso was educated in creating art. Shakespeare was educated in the art of all that was written. Colonel Harlan Sanders was educated in the art of creating Kentucky Fried Chicken. I once saw David Beckham take a free kick. I watched as the side of his Adidas-sponsored boot hit the patent leather of the ball at an angle which caused it to travel towards the skies as though it was destined for the heavens. And then as it reached the peak of its momentum, as though it changed its mind, it switched directions. I watched as the goalkeeper froze, as though reciting to himself the laws of physics, and as though his brain was negotiating with his eyes that it was indeed witnessing the spectacle of the leather swan that was swooping towards it, and then reacting, but only a fraction of a millisecond too late. And before the net of the goal embraced the FIFA-sponsored ball as though it was the prodigal son returning home, and the country that I live in erupted into cheers, I looked at the play and thought, damn, looking at David Beckham, there's more than one way in this world to be an educated man.
Wow. That just inspired me. You guys, we're approaching the top of the hour. You're still listening to the African Queen Show. And that was Sully Breaks, the phenomenal Sully Breaks, with Why He Hates School but Loves Education. We'll be right back. I got some great music for you as well. Stay tuned right here on 102.5 Choice FM.
The